Thank you very much. Dank u allemaal. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This session is in English, huh? You know? I'll do my best. Today, we are starting the new academic year, and we are starting this very special year of celebrating 200 years Faculty of Science here in Leiden. Two centuries of excellent research and education in a broad range of disciplines. We're going back to look back at these 200 years with different speakers, and I will check what everybody knows about this period in an interactive quiz. My name is Gregor Bak. I'm your chairman this hour, and I'm just a simple musicologist. So I'm very impressed by everything you do and everything that has to do with science and algebra and all the ellende meer. As chairman, I always like to use in these kind of occasions music. And why music? Because music is above all the best way to communicate with each other. The best communication medium there is. In no time, in just a few notes, I can tell a whole story and give a lot of information. I just have to play this. And after these few notes, you know, it's interactive, eh? What do you know? Alba, very good. What else? Ajax wordt kampioen. Yeah, after all, you're right. The winner takes it all, and maybe Ajax. Alba, you know Agneta, you know Annifrit, you know Björn Benny. You know they won the Eurovision Song Contest in 1974. Very good. Maybe you know Sweden, you know IKEA, you know lasagna, you know horse meat. It's all in those few notes. For the Dutch people, I just have to play this. And you know, what do you know? Fransje Bauer. What else? Heb je één voor mij? Uiteindelijk getrouwd met Mariska. Vier jongens, Jan, Christian, Kleine, Fransje, Lucas. It was the title music of his soap about his life. Heb je één voor mij? Maybe you think about Afhaal Chinees, Babi Pangang. It's all in these few notes. I just have to play. I'm riding in your car. Yeah, exactly. Fire, very good, very kind. With a few notes, you know, Fire, Pointer Sisters, Three Beautiful Girls, daughters of a reference in America, the song written by Bruce Springsteen. And maybe you think about love, passion, well, something hot. I just need to play. Precies, u maakt hem gewoon af. The name of the composer, please. Mozart, very good. Meneer de Beest. His back neighbor, heel goed. Mozart, and you know, with his few notes, Mozart, Vienna, genius, a wonder child, ladies, men, Frauenliebhaber, womanizer, classic period of Vienna, Salzburg, Mozart, Kugeln, Kugelsverzeichnis 525. You know it, yeah. But all this information is incorporated in just a few notes, but also without this extra information, you can say about music of Mozart, it's optimistic, cheerful, festive, sunny, sparkling. You think of the silver medal won by the Leidse wiskundestudent Onno Berrevoets, hey? On the International Mathematics Competition in Bulgaria, or the great news that Aad van der Vaart, professor of statistics at Leiden University, has been awarded the NWO and WO Spinoza Award for his groundbreaking research in statistics. That's positive news, it's great. Or you think of 200 years Leiden science. It's completely different when it sounds like this. I I just changed one note and you get a different feeling. Eh? It's a bit sad, a bit misery, a bit crisis, China, a bit Bram Moscovici. This universal, ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't matter in what language we communicate, we all know what music will tell us. And we got touched by some ingredients of it. And the fun, through the centuries, these ingredients have not changed a lot. Maybe you know this piece, Back to History, often used at the funerals. Bach, very good. Valt me mee hoor, van die wiskundige. Bach, and the name of the piece? Air, very good. Air from his third orchestral suite. And if you listen to this piece, very good, very good. Mr. Van Delft, Procol Harum, A Wider Shade of Pale. And between those pieces, there are 250 years, but they're using the same ingredients. And that's the strength of the music, the descending skill. That's a line, we call it a descending scale. And this descending scale is used for a lot of songs. Maybe you know this song, they sing it in England. Have you seen the old folks? Ta-da-da-da-la-la-li. Streets of London. Ta-di. Using the descending scale. In France they sing, oh, Champs-Élysées. Ta-ti-ta-ti-ta. Oh. On every Dutch wedding they sing it, eh? Oh, Annie en Henk. Of, oh, Christa en Kees. Verschrikkelijk. In Spain, they use this descending skill. Eres tu. Ta-da-di-da-da-da-da-da. The very nice, very beautiful singer, Frans Halsema, used this descending skill for. Zij verstaat de kunst van bij me horen. In mijn lichaam heeft ze plaats gemaakt voor twee. Same skill. Nina Simone let us hear the descending skill very clearly. My baby just cares for me. And Paul de Leeuw uses this descending skill also. Vlieg met me mee naar de regenboog. Ik hou zoveel van jou. Vlieg met me mee naar de regenboog. Ik hou zo van. En even Marco Borsato, lieve mensen. Marco Borsato uses this skill. Zij. Na, 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 na. And in a split second, you are from classical music, from Bach tot Borsato. Why am I telling you this? Because a descending scale is a beautiful ingredient for the introduction of the speakers this afternoon. So let's get started with the first speaker, the Dean of the Faculty of Science and Professor of Conservation Biology. I'll do it half in Dutch, half in English, because Geert de Snow has a different meaning in English. Eh? It's a bit. So I do it in Dutch. Aandacht voor de man die zoveel weet en zoveel kan. Studeerde zelf in Amsterdam toen hij daarna als onderzoeker naar Leiden kwam. Hij promoveerde, werd hoogleraar in Wageningen en hier. Werkt op het CML met groot plezier. Biodiversiteit, milieu en natuurbeheer. Bij hem ben je graag in de leer. Hij is nationaal en internationaal expert. Zijn kennis reikt dan ook heel ver. Vandaag is hij precies 3 jaar decaan. Gaat er volop tegenaan. Today exactly he is dean for 3 years. There is nothing that he fears. Attention for the man that is opening this jubilee show. Ladies and gentlemen, Geert de Snow.
Poo. I've never had such an introduction. I hear a wonderful speech, but I don't think it fits to the first part of the wonderful event we have here. I try. Meneer de burgemeester, meneer de vicevoorzitter van het college van bestuur, ladies and gentlemen. This afternoon, we are together for a special moment. On the 2nd of August of this year, our faculty celebrates her 200th birthday. A milestone that we celebrate not only today, but throughout the rest of the academic year. I've never seen such a large number of staff and students of our faculty in one room for a celebration. So I think you all agree that 200 years of science in Leiden is something to be proud of. What is it that we are celebrating exactly? In 1815, King William I, a wise man, signed a new law for higher education, also known as Organiek Besluit. In this declaration, it was made clear that in our country, there should be three universities. First, Leiden, then Utrecht, and then Groningen. And within these universities, the traditional faculty of Artes Liberales was split, and the faculty for natural sciences and mathematics was created. Our faculty started small. For the first decades, the number of professors was restricted by law to only four professors. And there was a small group of supporting staff and students. Looking to today, we are larger than ever before, with more than 100 full professors, 600 PhDs, and a solid group of supporting staff. 200 years ago, only a small part of society was connected with science. In most cases, daily life was not directly influenced by scientific developments. Training in higher education was restricted to the upper class. Nowadays, it's obvious that the impact of science and the way science is connected with our daily lives has changed enormously. Higher education has come within the reach of many students throughout society. And at the moment, there are more than 3,000 students in our faculty. The impact of scientific discoveries over time in society has been overwhelming. Scientific breakthroughs and insights from theory and experiments have been translated and transformed in all kinds of technologies. It enables us to travel to other planets and expand our lifetime. And with our mobile phone, we all are connected, and we have access to more scientific knowledge than can be stored in libraries. Moreover, modern society expects that science will continue to improve our well-being. The debate around the Wetenschapsagenda makes clear that people would like researchers to focus on solving persistent problems like climate change, cancer, and so on. Over the last 200 years, the Faculty of Science of Leiden University has contributed a lot to the development of science in society. Thousands of students with solid knowledge of their discipline have graduated here. And with our research on the fundamentals of science and the bioscience, we have been able to work at the frontiers of science. The credits for this are for the people behind the science, teachers and top scientists with bright minds persistent in finding answers, proving theories, explaining the world around us, from the nanoscale up to the universe. I'm proud of our science community, inspired teachers, Spinoza laureates, colleagues that have been granted prestigious awards, tenure trackers, but also the people that build and manage the instruments, those who make it possible to do the experiments, and the people supporting the scientific staff by taking care for finance and human resources. Because in the end, human capital and a strong community is what matters most. Ladies and gentlemen, the motto of our Lustrum year is "We are science." It's about science and education, but it is also about celebrating our staff, students, and the joint capacity of our community, past, present, future. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dean Geert de Snow. With great pleasure, I'm going to introduce the next speaker on a descending scale. Geboren in de Achterhoek in Winterswijk. Als een echte beta voelde hij zich de koning te rijk. Studeerde in Groningen bedrijfseconomie. And started his own company. He sold it almost 20 years ago. Werd bestuurder in het onderwijs in hoog tempo. After Den Bosch, Eindhoven and Twente University, he was asked for Leiden, a dream, seriously. Vicevoorzitter college van bestuur. Maar daarnaast werkt hij menig uur in het bestuur van de HBO-raad en VSNU. En Leiden Bioscience Park zit in zijn menu. Combining science with entrepreneurship. Hij is dan ook echt een begrip. De tweede spreker op dit jubileumfeest. Uw aandacht voor Willem, Willem de Beest.
Ja, kom daar nog maar eens overheen, hè. Dear all, I never saw so many people in this lecture room. So I'm very glad to see you. On behalf of the executive board of the university, I congratulate the members and all the former members of the board and of the staff of this faculty and all the students and alumni of the Faculty of Science with this remarkable milestone, 200 years Faculty of Science at Universiteit Leiden. I deliberately did not say 200 years of science in Leiden. Scaliger, one of the first professors in Leiden, was not only an expert in at least 12 languages, but also an authority in astronomy. Clusius created the Hortus Botanicus already 425 years ago, and the anatomical theater was founded in the year 1595. And Boerhaave, Schravenzande, and Albinus need no further explanation, I assume. One of the first students in Leiden was Maurits, son of our founder, Willem van Oranje. Maurits became the most successful army general of his time. And that was not only because he studied the organization and operations of the Roman army in Tacitus under Lipsius. It was mostly because of his fellow student and friend, Simon Stevin. Stevin came as a very advanced bookkeeper from Brugge to study in Leiden, He then already published the Table of Interest, and he became, so to speak, king of numbers. He was an engineer, a mathematician, and an inventor. After 1 year, he already registers his first patents. I was looking for the IP, but I couldn't find it anywhere. In the battlefield, Maurits and Simon Stevin were inseparable. Stevin was Maurits' teacher in mathematics, navigation, fortification, and artillery. And Maurits was his patron and protected him, even when Simon Stevin was criticized by Ubbo Emmius because he, Simon, claimed that the Earth turned around the sun. So, science was in Leiden from the first years on. In 1815, it was actually only a bureaucratic measure. The new kingdom got a new constitution and a new law on higher education, as he told you, the Organiek Besluit. And according to this law, there should be 5 faculties. Nobody knows why, but there should be 5 faculties. And the faculty of Artes, arts, was divided in a faculty of letters and a faculty of mathematics and natural sciences. And I doubt whether that was a wise decision, because before that, we had a real groundbreaking education in liberal arts and sciences. And when you visit Stanford or Berkeley, you will learn that they still have a faculty of science and humanities or science and letters. That's the original heart of the university. And all the other disciplines are in schools, actually more or less professional. But it was a bureaucratic message, but the law had some very nice text, and I'm sure you will like it, especially the professors here will like it. The law prescribed that the higher education should be highly educational. Well, the Dutch word would be erudiet. And the university started with a very broad education. So whatever you wanted to study, you had to start in either the faculty of letters or the faculty of mathematics and natural sciences. So when you want to be a physician, Pankras, then you should first study mathematics and natural sciences. The professor was in that law set on a pedestal. And every education for profit, for utility, or for practical use was rejected. And some of you will remember the discussions we had regarding the word impact in the research chapter in our strategic plan, Freedom to Excel. Should the word impact be in it or not in it? Well, finally it came in, but I don't know whether you agree. But well, if you like this, I must disappoint you, because with all laws, it happened also with this law, after 60 years a new law was introduced, and then from that point on, all the education was highly divided in very small disciplines. In the 20th century, this faculty hosted a number of Nobel Prize winners. Lorenz, Kamerling, Onnes, Eindhoven, the old uncle of my personal assistant, I'm very proud to say that every time, Einstein, Tinbergen. Their names can be found with others as Oort, De Sitter, and Ehrenfest on buildings and streets on the science campus. This already proves the importance of the science faculty for the Universiteit Leiden. But there is more. The number of students is fast growing for a number of years. In September, around 1,000 science students will start in the first year in this faculty. And that, I doubt it, whether I should say it, but that exceeds the number of first year law students this year. And this faculty is very successful in winning prizes and acquiring research projects. The second and third money stream even exceed the first money stream for research. It's actually not possible, but it happens. As a consequence, the student staff ratio is low. The faculty adopted a promising and already successful strategy of bringing research groups together around dedicated infrastructure. Some examples: the Cell Observatory, Center for Metabolomics, Center for Data Science. And actually, it's back to the beginning, because the founders and the first administrators of this university had the idea how to get this university famous, a young university. Acquired two brilliant professors and take care that you have very special, unique facilities. So in the beginning we had, of course, the library, Magna Commoditas, the Hortus Botanicus, the Anatomical Theater. And what you are doing now is around these large facilities, large infrastructure, building very strong groups over disciplines. And with the very important ORI projects, the research infrastructure is made available for scientists within and outside the university, be it academia or private companies. And last but not least, the Faculty of Science is the origin of many of the companies in the Leiden Bioscience Park. A number of them is based on the intellectual property of the pharmaceutical research in the different institutes and in the Faculty of Medicine. Pankas would call it LUMC, Faculty of Medicine. In the studies that are performed by Bigger Economics, the impact of Universiteit Leiden is estimated at 3.9. That means that every euro that is invested in research in this university generates a contribution of 3.9 euro to the gross product of our country. And I'm convinced that a very important part of that is due to your contribution to society and to the Leiden Bioscience Park. On behalf of the Executive Board of the University and of the colleagues in all the other faculties, I thank you for your contribution in the past 200 years, and actually in the past 440 years. That we all appreciate your work becomes clear when you look at the building activities next to the current faculty. Gert-Jan, it's there. Should I point there? There? There, over there. And what's very new is that this morning, the Executive Board has decided that we will start a tender for the second phase of the new Beta Campus, with the explicit, explicit approval of the Supervisory Board and the University Council. Both had to agree with this next step, and that they did proves once more that the entire university community highly appreciates the work that is done in this faculty. So, we count on you for the next 200 years. Noblesse oblige. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Willem te Beest. Now we're going to talk about a book, a very special book about your faculty, about 200 years science in Leiden, het lustreboek van kabinet naar Science Park. And I'm going to introduce one of the writers and compilers. He studied physics merrily. And 10 years ago, he became professor in the history of material heritage of the science in Leiden University. Hij stond in Noordwijk, 17 jaar, Noordwijkerhout, 17 jaar voor de klas. Werkte bij NRC Handelsblad, waar hij 13 jaar werkzaam was. Nu dus hoogleraar en directeur van Museum Boerhaven. Dat haalde hij uit de sleur. Hij doet de dingen goed, nooit voor de helft. Hier is Dirk, Dirk van Delft. Mr. Dirk van Delft, one of the writers of the Jubilee book. Was it a nice experience to write this book?
Yes, of course. Writing is fun, always fun, kind of a blessing. But editing is a hell of a job.
Editing, yeah, takes a lot of time.
A lot of time at night. Of course, you're striving kind of equilibrium between all the parts of the faculty and so on. So that's a hard job, but I hope we succeeded.
You write, you do the editing in the middle of the night? You are married?
Yes.
Okay. Did you find things you did not know before?
Of course, all kinds of details. For example, Udo de Haas from Milieukunde, well, he confessed he had prevented that the location of the Leiden Medical Hospital became at the highway. Now it's, fortunately, it's at the railway station. So that's a nice detail. Yeah, yeah. And all kinds of such details I learned, yes.
Most spectacular thing you did find?
Impressed me that, as a scientist, of course, you need to go beyond frontiers. And therefore, you need extra laboratory room, you need extra apparatus or people or money. And therefore, of course, you need to convince. And convincing, of course, starts with complaining. And complaining, I learned from different examples, complaining is a kind of art. You have to complain with class. And I have two examples, well, to make my point. And
chic complainen, ja, geestig, ja. Complain with class.
Complain with class. The first one is from Keizer, professor of astronomy. Well, he needed a new observatory. And he was complaining about, he got some new instruments, but he said, he couldn't, he had to say that it was nice toys, it were nice toys for a dilettante, but completely unworthy for a university. So that's, and it helped because he got a nice Leiden observatory afterwards.
And you think that this is complaining with class?
Yes.
Okay.
Toys for a dilettante.
Oh yeah, toys for a dilettante, yeah. Yeah, no, quite simple.
Instead of saying thank you for all these new instruments, he said, toys for a dilettante. I think that's a nice way of complaining. The other one was Rijke. It was the predecessor of Kamerling Onnes, the guy of Absolute Zero. Yeah. And, he had a piece of room in the center of town, completely hopeless. It was dark, it was humid, completely hopeless. And he said, I think I have to tell it in Dutch. De docent kan veeltijds de bewegingen der werktuigen zelf niet zien en moet aan zijn toehoorders vragen wat er gebeurt, die hem alleenlijk bij helder weder een voldoend antwoord kunnen geven.
It's class.
That's class. And I have to add one more thing to these two examples of complaining. Rijke got a new laboratory, the Kamerling Onnes laboratory, and nowadays, Leiden Observatory and the old Kamerling Onnes Laboratory are used by the law faculty. So the conclusion has to be they can complain best.
Mr. van Delft, last question, not unimportant. What's the price of this beautiful book?
It's relevant because it matters the price today. And the price today is only 5 euro. That's next to nothing.
Thank you very much. Dirk van Delft, dames en heren. Thank you. 5 euros. And that's the special offer only for today. Yeah? 5 euros. It's a very, very nice book. Now I'm going to check what you all know about your own history, about 200 years faculty. You have two papers, an orange one and a kind of blue one. It's very light blue. And you can make your choice by choosing one of the colors. We're going back to 1815 on the day of March 16 in the Trevenzaal op het Binnenhof in The Hague, the United Kingdom of the Netherlands is declared, and the son of Willem V is inaugurated as King Willem the First. Along with the new kingdom, this country gets a hoger onderwijswet, a higher law for education, het organiek besluit van 1815. I can't translate it in organic decision, I think, no. On which date exactly was the Faculty of Wis- en Natuurkundige Wetenschappen set? Was it, and now we see it on the screen, was it blue, the 2nd of August, or orange, the 2nd of September? You can choose. And the right answer is blue. A month ago, the 2nd of August. 2nd of August, ooh. And in that law, ladies and gentlemen, het organiek besluit was decided that the language for education was Latin. Latin, wow, amazing. All in Latin. Question two, the next question has to do with... Professors in Utrecht and Groningen earned a salary of 2,200 guilders yearly, and not monthly. How much did the professors earn in Leiden? Blue, 2,500 guilders, or orange, 2,800. And most of you has the right answer. Orange, 2,800. That's almost 28% more. And it's a pity for you that these rules are changed nowadays. But it was because Leiden was the eldest university, the then so-called Eerste Hogeschool, die voorrang kreeg in subsidiën en tractementen. Ik citeer het Lustrumboek. In this same year, 1815, a beautiful piece is written by a famous Austrian composer. Is indeed, no, it's Schubert orange. Oh, that's a pity. You choose all blue. Schubert is blue. You did it all right. Because Mozart was already dead then, 1815. He died in 1797. Very good of you. Oh, they changed the color. Sorry. We are still in the same year, 1815. There was a quite famous battle in that year, June 18th. I'll give you a little hint. Yeah. Has anyone... Yeah! Orange! No, it's blue. It was a joke. Waterloo. Of course it was the Battle of Waterloo. Question five. Oh, Waterloo. Spoken about Napoleon. Waterloo, the final loss of Napoleon Bonaparte. Spoken about Napoleon. He once visited Leiden University, Napoleon, and asked which system you follow here. The system of Boerhaave or the system of Brown. And Sebald Justinus Brugmans gave the answer, Sire, nous professeurs cherchons la vérité partout. We're always looking for the truth. It's in the Jubilee book. For these Brugmans followed Linnaeus in botany, in the zoology, Cuvier, medicines, Brown. He followed Franz Josef Gall in anthropology and in chemistry, Lavoisier. But you all know that. On December 10, in 1815, the same year, still 1815, in England, there was born a little baby, a girl, who became a gifted mathematician. In those days, there were no place for girls in the United Kingdom's universities, but girls from wealthy aristocratic families could still be educated to a high level by private tutors. And this is how she was educated, this little girl. She concentrated on mathematics and science and is considered to have written instructions for the first computer program in the mid-1800s. Who was this lady? Was it Blue Mary Somerville or Orange Ada Lovelace? And you all, almost all, choose the right answer, Ada Lovelace, very good, Orange. Not to confuse with Linda Lovelace, huh? Oh, you know, completely different category. Back to Leiden, ladies and gentlemen. What was the main scientific institute of the Leiden University in the first half of the 19th century? The main scientific institute, was it Blue Natural History Museum or was it Orange Hortus Botanicus? And that's quite surprising. It was the Museum of Natural History. And Dirk van Delft was the only one who had the right answer, yeah. But he wrote the book. And you too, sorry. It was the Museum of Natural History with two giants over there, Brugmans and Mr. Temmink. And Brugmans was engaging and Temmink arrogant and sarcastic. After Temmink, the new director was Schlegel, like a football talent. He was scouted by Temmink in Vienna and he was brought to Leiden. With a new and different policy, the collection grew immense. How many animals you think were there in 1882? It's not a question, or 6,000, 42,000, 100,000, 200,000? What do you think? How much animals? Museum of Natural History, 214,555. It's amazing. Schlegel was a bit... okay. Question 7. The boss of the Hortus Botanicus was Mr. Brugmans. And after him, Reinwart de Vries. And in 1862, Mr. Seurringer. Willem Frederik Reinier Seurringer. Only 25 years old and looking very young. The students called him het jonge heertje. Een beetje mannetje, het jonge heertje. Young man. And Seurringer tried to compensate his lack of outward respectability by, and that's the question, by wearing a high hat, blue, or orange platform shoes. Yeah, you're doubting. The right answer is a high hat. This is the only picture of Mr. Seurringer without a hat. Marlijn found that picture. Question 8. The Leidse Sterrenwacht, oftewel the Leiden Observatory, has a long, long history since 1632. In 1817, there was Cornelis Ekema, and he got it done that the observatory was extended with a platform and a tower of 4 floors with a turnable roof. Great. He bought a new telescope. The whole backside of the Academiegebouw was rebuilt for this telescope. But there was one problem with this telescope. 1817. What was the problem? The telescope was much too large, you choose blue, or the telescope was completely useless. En waarom kiezen jullie nou oranje?
I thought the orange answer included the blue one.
Smart guys! Wow! But orange was the good answer. Completely useless because he was built by een stelletje amateurs in Friesland. Dat heeft niets met Friezen te maken hoor. Maar alleen dat het amateurs waren. Question 9. Physics in Leiden was changed in 1877 as if by magic, in a positive sense, in a positive way, with the appointment of 2 heroes, Lorentz and Kamerling Onnes. Hun namen vielen al. 2 absolute top scientists. How old were they together at the time of their appointment, not at the time of the picture, but at the time, 82, no, at the time of their appointment together. Was it 53 together or 63 orange? And the right answer is orange. No, no, blue. Sorry, 53 years together. Lawrence was only 24 years, very young, and Kamerling, almost brilliant as he was, 29. Quite young, eh? Quite young. So 53 together. Question 10. In 1984, there were steps by the government to concentrate courses. Leiden University lost geology and pharmacy, but there came a new research training, BFW, Biopharmaceutical Science. My question, how many students start this year this education? Blue, less than 300, or orange? A very hard question. And the right answer is, of course, orange. More than 300 new students this year. Great, eh? Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, my last question. Leiden Institute of Chemistry. Leiden Institute of Chemistry is great. And there's a lot of collaboration with the University of Delft. My question is about one of the contributions of your faculty to a very, very, very important research, especially for lovers of French fries. Leiden researchers were involved in the investigation of, and you have to choose, blue, fat-free ketchup, or orange, fat-free mayonnaise. And I've got news for you, ketchup is already fat-free. So the right answer is mayonnaise. Nay, in ketchup there is no fat. Check the label of the Heinz ketchup, you see, no fat. That was my last question. Who from you, wie had alle antwoorden goed? Eentje? Congratulations, immortal fame for you. Ladies and gentlemen, your future will even be more amazing with a new science campus, the whole faculty on one location, one spot. And in the meantime, Leiden science may be a little less modest. Jullie zijn te bescheiden. You have to be more proud. You have to bit more beat the drum. And maybe you have to be more and more visible. And I think music can help you in that process. If you want a very clear communication, you must connect a musical theme to your product. And it works always. I can play a tune and you know all what it's about. It's amazing. You all know Nokia, based on a grand vase of a Spanish composer. If I play this, you all know. Dienstmededeling. NS. Oh, you never travel by train? Er is weer een reiziger tegen een trein aangelopen. Vervang het vervoer door bussen. In advertising, they use good tunes. I just have to play. Randstad Uitzendbureau. Even the name of Randstad Uitzendbureau is not mentioned in the commercial. They just do. Nationale Nederland. If I play this tune, you smell it already. Je bent thuis, waar je douwe Egbert drinkt. So, your faculty needs a good tune. Also, to communicate the new campaign of your faculty, we are science. I called Xander de Buissonnier. You know Xander de Buissonnier? Xander de Buissonnier is a Dutch singer, and he sings most of the time about love and hou me vast and allemaal van die ellende. And Xander suggests this song. Everybody knows it doesn't matter who owns a great idea or where they're from. What really matters is where you take them to and where the idea is taking you. Great ideas need people who see the world not as it is, but see the world how it can be. In Leiden, all those talents have the key. We are science. Since 1815, we are science. With history, we are science. New campus comes with energy for all those talents at Leiden University. But thank you. I'm going to finish this little musical intermezzo with a 200 years Leiden science song, and you can sing along with me. The lyrics are, we are science. Mathematics, astronomy, computer science, biology, biopharmaceutical, environmental and statistical science too, chemistry and physics. Here is a lot to do. We are science celebrating 200 years. Leading research, shifting frontiers. Leading education, developing great minds. Great minds. We are science. We are science. We are science. You. We are science. Very good. Next verse. Scientific impacts relevant for society. In the world top five, the observatory. Spinoza Prize winners and ERC advanced grants. A lot of great talents. Talents who invent. Science in Leiden celebrating 200 years. Leading research, shifting frontiers. Technological innovation through great minds. Great minds. Leiden science, we are science, we are science. Thank you. Nice choir. Ladies and gentlemen, time for official things. The handing over of the first Luster book. May I ask Dean Geertes now to come to the stage.
Thank you, Mr. Gregor Bach. It was the quiz was inspiring, but I loved, of course, the science song, We Are Science. I think it will be on YouTube, and wonderful. Thank you very much.
We have to talk about the rights, sorry.
It's all on tape. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very proud that we have a Lustrum book, and there are all the answers. All the answers on every question, I think, about our history of 200 years Faculty of Science. And the most important writers of the book are Dirk van Delft, Frans van Lunteren, and Willem Otterspeer. They have made an enormous contribution. They wrote the book next to their daily busy schedules, sometimes even in the late or very early hours. I really was impressed. They were able to give an insight in the history of our faculty and also wrote some portraits of some of our professors. So I would take the opportunity to thank them. Dirk, Frans and Willem, thank you very much. Receive your own copy. You haven't seen the book yet. So I would like to welcome now Mr. Lemfrink, our mayor of the city of Leiden. And I'm very happy that you are here with us this afternoon to celebrate this special moment to our faculty. Mr. Lemfrink, it is an honor to have you here today. The city of Leiden and our university, our faculty, are closely connected. That is also why, with great pleasure, we would like to present the first copy of our Lustrum book to you. And I'm sure that, being an historian, you will be able to appreciate the book. So would you come forward?
Well, Mr. De Beest, Vice Chairman of our famous university, Mr. De Snow, Dean of this important faculty, distinguished guests, dear students, 200 years is quite a lot. As a mayor, I always visit those who reach the age of 100. But I can't remember to have seen many with the age of 200. So today's celebration seems to be justified. But on the other hand, as we heard from Mr. De Beest, one could argue that 200 years isn't that old at all. Leiden University itself is 440 years old. And we now know that many of the fields that are studied by this university, by this faculty, already were studied by professors at Leiden University in the period before 1815. So it wasn't completely terra incognita. But when you look at these professors, these scientists, in those days they were all called philosophers. And I don't think that present-day scientists like to be remembered as such. But is time really important? According to Einstein, the only reason for time is so that everything doesn't happen at once. So once again, it's a good idea to have a celebration today, although it wasn't because of new local insights, of new ideas, that the new faculty was founded, but because of a new law. We just heard about it, inspired by the French system and issued by the new King William I. It just was called a wise man. I'm not sure whether this was true. He was a master in shadow bookkeeping, and at the end of his reign, Holland was just as broke as Greece is today. But in the end, the new faculty proved to be a good idea. And it brought new energy in science, and this contributed enormously to the fame of Leiden University. New laboratories were built in the old town, new discoveries and inventions were made. Everything seemed to be planned. Although, according once again to Einstein, researchers normally didn't know what it was they were doing. Otherwise, it wouldn't be called research. And although today the main activities of the faculty are concentrated on the Leiden Bioscience Park, one can still see the beautiful 19th century buildings nowadays used for different purposes all over the historical town. It contributes to the character of Leiden as an historical university town, so we have to take care of these memories of the past. And I'm always happy that Leiden University shares this view and cherishes not only its traditions, but also its heritage. Leiden University has always been very important for Leiden as a town during the past centuries. Students made the town lively and brought economic activity. Imagine a city where they don't have those large numbers of bright young men and women. I'm sure you can come up with one. Compare them with Leiden, and then you know which one is to be preferred. University as a whole brings jobs and new ideas, valuable for society and sometimes useful for businesses. The local government hasn't always recognized the value of the academia, but important it was. It gave Leiden prestige, and the last decades it contributed enormously to the economic recovery of the city after the old industry vanished completely. Nowadays, Leiden has become a knowledge city, and we are proud of it. Knowledge-based economy and knowledge-based society have become the central themes of our policy. And in this, the Faculty of Science plays a key role. It can be considered to be one of the most important engines for the development of the Leiden Bioscience Park, which is the biggest in the Netherlands and already one of the biggest in Europe. The faculty is a supplier of new ideas that further economic activity in the area. Its presence is attractive for businesses. Perhaps the meaning for society in this way can become even stronger in the future. It must be tried at least, although fundamental research without immediate use in the real world must stay one of the key pillars of research. The Faculty of Science also delivers first-class bachelors and masters. Society needs these people. People who can help to find new solutions to technical problems, but can also contribute to solutions for the big challenges of Mother Earth. For the vast majority, it's easy to find a job, and that's proof enough of their value. For decades, it was difficult to attract enough young people to study exact sciences. Even governmental campaigns didn't help enough. Talented pupils decided to study something completely different. And I must admit, I also was one of these. Numbers are not incorrect letters to me. They help me to understand reality. I was pretty good in mathematics. But nevertheless, I choose to study history. Fortunately, for me at least, I did find a decent job. But the economic crisis convinced many young people to choose a study with better perspectives for a job. And so the science department is growing quickly, just as we have wanted for decades. And it might now be difficult to accommodate everyone. But future society will be happy for all the efforts that have been put in educating so many young people. together with the renewal of the faculty buildings, this predicts a new, glorious, and golden future for Leiden Faculty of Science, and because of that, a little bit for Leiden as a town as well. And I'm proud of that. Congratulations, and thank you for the book.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time is there. There was a lot of presentations, words, and real nice music. It's time for action. So I just suggest we push the button together. Okay? Yes, maybe you will introduce a bit of music. Yeah.